How's it going, guys? Bradley Sutton from Helium 10, and I'm going to give you guys an overview of Magnet 2, which is our keyword research tool. We just had a recent user interface update, and I wanted to be able to show you guys how to navigate around it. We've got some cool new filters that might help you in your keyword research, and maybe this is your first time using Magnet. Where do you begin? All right, you begin by entering a keyword right here under the keyword box. Let's go ahead and do my famous collagen peptides, and we will go ahead and search. By the way, guys, you could do this search in Canada, Germany, Spain, Italy, France, or the UK. I'm going to pick USA right now. Let's go ahead and hit search. I have searched this before. I've probably searched this 1,000 times. All right. So now we have a list of keywords here, 4,822 keywords. All right. So the question is, where in the world do these keywords come from? I'm going to make separate videos about where exactly these keywords are coming from, each of these different data points. But let me just briefly go over it. Organic keywords, what does that mean? That means that we are taking some of the top selling products in this niche and checking what other keywords they might be ranking fairly high for. All right. And because of that, you're going to get some keywords that don't even have collagen or peptides in them, but that still could be relevant to your listing. So very powerful that to have that. The next one is Smart Complete. Smart Complete basically are the keywords that have collagen and peptides in some form in them. Like it could have peptides or it could have peptides, you know, plural. If there's other tenses or other plural or singular or other tenses of these words, it's going to show up. That's why it's called smart complete as opposed to just a simple auto complete. All right. So that's another data source. The last data source is Amazon recommended. We go more into detail on that in Cerebro. Basically, again, Amazon has scores for every keyword as it relates to certain ASINs. So what we're doing is we're going out there and finding those top selling ASINs in this category and then seeing what words that Amazon recommends for those ASINs, all right? And then that is what is displayed here is 2,700 of these words, all right? So how would you use Magnet, all right? I like to use it in order to find different ideas for different keywords. Like let's go ahead and do a couple of these filters right here. Like for example, let's do a smart complete. All right. So I know I want smart complete, or I know I want collagen peptides in my listing, but I'm just wondering, hey, since I have collagen peptides in my listing, what other words that have collagen peptides in them that have search volume might I use? And look at this. There's 1,181 different keywords that have some kind of activity on Amazon that have collagen and peptides in them. You know, fish collagen peptide serum, collagen peptides face cream. You know, who would have known that there's a such thing as that? Collagen peptides gummies. You're going to have a collagen peptides here, not just at the beginning of the word, but you're going to have it here at the end. You know, Verisol collagen peptides. Right in the middle of the phrase, vital proteins, collagen peptide packs. This gives you just tons of different keywords that you might be able to utilize in your listing. Since you already have collagen and peptides, that means all you have to do to index for these other phrases is just put the other words that are in there. So this is something that can help you. By default, let me open this back up again. We've got the word count at 2. You know, usually I like to have the word count at 2 minimum because sometimes when you get singular keywords, not many people search for singular keywords. Actually, in collagen peptides, there might be one like collagen. I could see somebody. So that's not going to show up here. So I would have to put that to word count at least minimum 1 if I want to see collagen. But this helps. This little filter helps in order to weed out some of the words that you might feel are irrelevant. All right, what else do we have here? We have, by the way, there's an advanced filters. This is by default what shows up. If you click on advanced filters, you can have show phrases that contain. There's a video about that. Exclude phrases that contain. There's a pro training video on that as well. Amazon's choice only, basically that is showing where one of these products, you know, one of these top products had Amazon's choice on there. If there's nothing here, that means when we did this search, there was no product on this search that had Amazon's choice. All right. So what are some of the titles? All right. The column titles. What do they mean? What does each one mean? Here's the phrase. Makes sense, right? Magnet IQ score. Magnet IQ score, we have a video specifically about that, so make sure to watch that one. Basically, it's just the relationship between the number of competing products and the search volume. Doesn't mean if something is good or bad, all right? So make sure for more information to take a look at that. We've got estimated search volume. We've also got a video about that. Make sure to watch that one. Sponsored ASINs, this is the number of products that we have detected advertising via a sponsored ad for this keyword. So for example, if we go here to matcha collagen peptides, okay, we're gonna see right here, 1, 2, 3, 4. There's four sponsored ads right here. So if we had done a detection on this at this given moment, we would have detected here, here's four different products that all are showing sponsored ads for this search, all right? So actually total, we have detected 18 for that search, all right? Headline ASINs, what are headline ASINs? Headline search ads are these up here. So this one here is for this bulletproof collagen protein bars. So we have detected one three headline ASINs for this search. These three products came up in a headline search ad. And look, there we have it. There's those three right there. Number of competing products. If we search here, these are the number, like this one has 31. So different browsers show different amounts at times. So we had said 34 here in Chrome. I'm signed in, or actually I'm not signed in. So it's showing 31. So you'll see something very close to this number that's going to come up. 8-day giveaways, CPR. This is the number that you would have to do a giveaway with or at a highly discounted price that's sending traffic to a certain search using maybe a two-step URL in order to give you the best chance of getting to page one for this keyword, all right? Match type, what we have here is smart complete is S. If it says A, it's Amazon recommended. And if it says O, those are organic searches. So sometimes it might be cool. You can actually say, hey, are there any keywords that match all three types? All right, so we're gonna filter that down here. And there's actually 181. So you can see here that bioactive collagen peptides is both something that's organically ranked. It's showing up for Smart Complete. And it's also showing as Amazon recommended. So that's another way to get some valuable keywords. What else do I like to use? I really like to use a Smart Complete with collagen peptides or for any other search I'm doing because I can get tons of ideas that I never would have thought about that have that seed word in it. So like if you have some main phrases that you're gonna use in your listing, do a magnet search for each of those and use Smart Complete to find out how easily you could index for other keywords that are getting search volume just by adding one or two words. Like for example, where's here? This is one, like collagen peptides is your main word, right? So if this would have come up right here, this would have come up in your magnet Smart Complete search. And so I would have just had to put 20 in ounces, and I would have indexed for this since I already know I have collagen peptides in my listing. Creamer, all right? There's a word. This is a really cool word right here, collagen peptides creamer. A lot of people use collagen peptides as a creamer for their coffee, right? So to index for this, if I already have collagen peptides in my listing, all I have to do is put creamer. All right, so how would I know what the individual words are? Make sure to watch the video about how to export to Frankenstein. All right, how to export to Frankenstein. That is going to show you how you can filter out all of these duplicate words and how you can get these valuable keywords with your Smart Complete. All right, guys, so I hope that you're using Magnet in your keyword research. You're gonna get a lot of ideas that you might never have thought about. Don't forget, if you're using Magnet or you're trying to make a listing in another marketplace such as Canada or UK, don't just copy your English listing. Make sure to do this search all over again right here using Magnet with California. I always think CA is California, but Canada or Spain or UK, etc. One last thing. History. This is going to show you all of the searches that you have done. So something happens in the middle of your search, you don't have to automatically save it, or you don't have to manually save it. It's going to automatically save it. You can come back here and hit history, and you'll see all of the different searches that you have done, and then repost it right here. So guys, make sure to check out this learn button. I said that there are other videos, so hit this learn button here in the magnet dashboard, and then you'll see the rest of the videos about this. Thank you guys, and I hope you crush it with your keyword research using Magnet.
What?